It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Cahoon family. Kathy, Karen, Celia, Helen, and Reed, ready for action. And the Dolven family. Terry, Beverly, Mike, Edith, and Ray. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud.
Reader, I've got to tell you, it was very gallant the way you helped the ladies down.
Thank you, sir.
Very unusual. Most of the guys just put their foot out. They're the champs. They're from Salt Lake City, the Cahoon. Very sweet of them to do that. He is kind of sweet, though, isn't he?
Yeah, he's just a big, lovable bear.
What time does he hibernate?
Well, hardly ever. Oh, he just keeps ever? Going all the time.
Dear. How much money did you win the last time you played?
$5,391. Yay! Yay! It's enough to get me out of personal debt.
Is it really? You've got to win more so you can all get out.
That's
right. Let's meet everybody.
I brought my identical twin sister, Karen.
Hello, Karen.
She
Hello.
Lives in a little town south of Salt Lake, quite a ways, Central.
Central.
My oldest sister, who lives in Peoa.
Peoa?
Uh-huh.
How's that spelled?
P-E-O-A. Mm. It has four vowels.
P-E-O-A.
No, three.
No, three, that's right. One consonant.
And that's Africa, by the way.
Yeah.
And who's next?
The child in our family who suffers from the middle child complex, Helen.
Helen, the middle child, sucking her thumb. And?
And baby brother Reed.
The big bear.
The big bear.
Nice to have you. Are you all married, all of you?
Yes, we all are.
Is Reed married?
Yes, he has two little boys.
Most of the time, Richard.
He lives in Peoa, too.
Does he really?
Yes.
What's the name of your children, Reed?
Dallas and Andrew.
You really like that show, don't you? Andrew show.
We have a big brother named Dallas.
Oh, do you?
And he was Dallas before Dallas was Dallas.
I think we all were deep down inside. Yeah. You remember this nice family? They were the champs before you dethroned them.
I have something for
you. What is this?
I enjoy needlework a lot, and if you like to read, you can mark
a
your place
mark?
By
I'd love to read, and I usually slip part of the book cover in, which is not good because my maid picks it up and says, oh, the cover is not in the right book. I've been on one book now 11 years. Did you make this?
Yes.
That's pretty. Thank you.
You're welcome.
And as you know, these rascals were the champs, and you dethroned them. But I held them over under a technicality that a policeman might not necessarily switch on a PA to scream. The Dolven, right out. Good. Before you were asked to leave, how much had you amassed?
$2,716.
Oh, that's
okay. Yeah, that's all right.
I should have let you go. I didn't realize it was that much. Let's meet. Let's meet everybody.
Okay, I got my wife, Beverly.
Hello, my darling.
Hi, Richard.
My baby brother, Mike.
Hi.
Michael.
His wife, Edith.
Hello, Richard.
Hello, Edith.
And our oldest daughter, Ray.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, Ray. Ray's got pretty legs.
Oh, I thought you were checking to see if Edith was the same on the front as you was.
No! But when we played yesterday, she had sort of a shorter skirt on, I noticed.
Yeah. Right.
Well, you weren't getting testy about that. She looked great. Everybody.
I think she looked all right.
Oh,
yeah. She looked good. Yeah, you bet.
We're going to play the feud. Let's go. Hundred people surveyed, top seven answers on the board. Long question, here it is. When you find a good physician, you stick with him or her. Name someone else you keep going to when you find a good one.
Hairdresser.
Hairdresser. One answer would be the correct.
Dentist.
A good dentist. You got it, Jeff.
Quiet, Richard.
Well, then. Well, he was the flake of the family at one time, and he's worked hard, and I'm proud of you.
Flakes came off.
You did very well.
Thank you.
When you find a good doc, stick with him or her. Name something else you keep going to when you find a good one.
Good grocery store. Well,
let's look. Grocery! Not there. Mikal. What would you say?
Well, what I am, an auto salesman or car dealership.
Okay.
All right, good answer, Mike. Good answer.
You mean if you get a good deal, you go back then?
You keep going back if you get a good car.
But until that day occurs.
Auto dealer? Oh.
Not there. I hate you to do hip lines there. Monsieur? Hmm. From Paris, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. If I find a good butcher, I keep going back.
Good, yeah, that's right. Good. Good meat. It's hard to find good
right.
Meat. Is there all right? If not, third strike. Butcher!
All right!
Well done. Well done. Well done. How are you, my little cutie pie? My little kumquat? My turtle dove?
How about a tailor, Richard?
Good tailor.
Yes.
Elizabeth.
Taylor.
Taylor! Oh, wow. No, $67. What do you say?
Psychiatrist.
Yeah,
well?
We're going to try psychiatry.
Doctor? Yeah, that's same as a doctor.
Then what do you want?
Restaurant.
A good restaurant.
All right, lover. If it's there, you get the $67. If not, Terry and the family get it. Restaurant! I thought it'd be there. Three.
Mechanic?
Is that mechanic?
Four.
Yeah, mine's inside at the moment. Six. Seven. Always go back to a good clergyman. And I asked him if he can recommend a good lawyer. We'll be back right after this.
Never have...
Let's go! People surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something women do when they feel a need for a change.
Yeah. Go for a walk.
A walk.
Style.
Change their hairstyle.
We'll play, Richard.
We'll play now. I'm very proud of you.
Thank you.
P, what's where you're born?
P, it's not where I was born. Oh, where you live now? Peoa.
P-E?
Peoa. P-E-O-A.
Is that an Indian word?
Well, there are several stories about that name, and one of them is it could be an Indian word.
What are the others?
Say it, Seal. Tell it.
A wagon train was coming through with a little girl named Oa.
I got you. I think I catch your drift, Dad. Now back to the business at hand. Something women do when they feel a need for change.
They buy a new dress.
Okay.
That's a good answer.
New dress, please. How are you doing, cutie pie?
Fine, thank you.
Something women do when they feel a need for change.
I think they have a change of scenery. They go out for a change of scenery.
Like where? They don't go for a walk because we've already had that.
Aha. Uh-huh. Different husband.
That's really changing the scenery. El Depart?
Pardon me?
El Departe, is that what you're saying?
El Departe.
They split?
Yeah, I would go for that one.
Oh, okay. Probably come as a shock to your husband, the fact that you're going, got a new hubby.
No.
How you doing there, Rita?
Great.
Good to see you. What do women do when they need to change?
Well, she just tells me what to do, but she makes me move the furniture around.
Oh, good answer.
Rearround all the furniture.
Oh, yeah, every bit of it. Okay. And it always ends back in the same place.
Rearrange the furniture.
Oh.
Kathy, Kathy.
They redecorate.
Oh. Is there okay, and if not thirsty, I redecorate. You got it.
Go visit a friend.
Good.
That's that's okay.
In Peoria.
Yeah.
Is there all right if not third strike? Visit a friend. $80. Big lead for you, Terry. Give me the right answer.
Get away, have an affair. Your choice.
We think an affair. Have an affair.
Right. I can't believe you were the one who instigated that.
I didn't.
No, Beverly was saying it. An affair, if it's there, big lead. If not, very even game, because Kathy, you get the $80. A foul! Ah! Five. I still like your idea, though, Beth. We'll be back right after this. Let's go. People survey, top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an occasion on which mom gets flowers.
Yeah. Anniversary.
Anniversary. Michael.
Her birthday.
On her birthday. Play a pass.
We'll play.
Well done. Move on. What a boogie. Boogie. What a. By the way, does he send you flowers on your birthday?
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
How about Mother's Day?
Yeah. Do you get them on Mother's Day?
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
It changes.
I want a little more consistency from you, Michael. Mother's Day. All right.
Okay. How about Easter?
Easter. Easter. Oh.
Terry?
When does mom get flowers?
Valentine's Day.
Yes. Good answer. Oh, he's smart tonight, isn't he?
Valentine? All right. He is smart. Mother's Day, you got flowers?
No.
Oh, birthday?
No.
He gives me.
I'm ashamed that I brought you back.
He gives me.
I give diamonds.
Oh, no. He does.
Does he?
He's good to me, yes.
All right, that's good. Well,
but you're going to make me forget my answer.
Oh, all right. The occasion mom gets flowers.
Christmas, a poinsettia.
All right.
Yes. Okay.
If you say you got it all, if not second strike. Christmas? No. I thought it was. Michael.
New Year's.
Good answer, Mike.
You don't even remember them on Mother's Day. Why the hell would you give them on New Year's? If it's there, you got it. If not, third strike. New Year? $97.
Come on, little cat.
What?
He needs to be forgiven.
Indication, mom gets flowers.
When she's in the hospital with a new baby, you're sick or something.
Now, I don't even know if it's there, but I kept looking at it deep. With child, I mean, the moment the baby's born, you're going to go in there with a big bunch of flowers. Shouldn't that be there? I think so. If it is, you get the $97, big lead. If not, Terry, you'll get it. Baby in the hospital. $177.67, let's go. But there is a good chance now that you will get flowers.
I hope so.
He's really embarrassed now. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something people open with their teeth.
Yeah.
Open with a carton of milk.
A carton of milk. No.
Candy.
Pardon?
Candy.
Rita said candy. Play. Three answers beat candy.
Oh, that's right. Oh, gosh.
3 seconds, darling.
Oh, I don't know.
Now, make the decision. Play or pass.
Play. I want to play.
Play.
Guys, look, are you done?
We're going to go for it.
We're going to play. Something people open with their teeth.
A bag of potato chips.
Yeah, that's good. Bag of potato chips. Very good.
Thank you. Oh, I open nail polish bottles. The lids are stuck on with my teeth.
They're hard to.
Yeah, and I.
You do.
I get nervous and get sweaty hands. See, and then it will hold on to the jar. And my teeth will go.
All right. Nail polish jaw. Found it.
That's great.
If you win a lot of money, I want you to promise me you'll have someone else do that for you.
See my teeth?
Yeah, you're going to end up with a broken jaw, dear. Opening a dill pickle bottle with your teeth. People open with their teeth.
My children don't like to peel oranges, and they bring them to me, and they say, open this, Mama, and I go, get the first bite out to start peeling the orange.
Yeah. Because there you have it all, and you keep your title. Orange! No? First strike, no problem. Helen, what do people open with their teeth? Three seconds. Okay. Reader?
They're male.
That's a good answer, Reed.
Right.
I'm going to sit right down and eat myself a letter. If it's there, you got it. If not, get ready. Mail. Nope. 38. Game goes on. You can give me the right answer.
Nuts.
Nuts.
Yeah, okay. If it's there, the game continues. If not, you keep your title. Nuts. That's right. I see ladies do that all the time. 67. Well, that's better than the 67 you didn't have. We added to 2,716. Thank you. You were nice. I'm glad you won money.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Sorry. Name the state with the all-round worst weather.
Alaska.
The age when you felt grown up.
18.
A comic book character.
Peanuts.
Something you put on a hamburger.
Ketchup.
A color on a bird.
Brown.
Turn around, Rita. Yeah. State with the all-round worst weather. Alaska! Survey! The age when you felt grown up. 18. Survey said. Hey! Comic book character Peanuts. Charlie Schultz. Survey. 2. Oh, okay. Something you put on a hamburger. Ketchup. Survey said. Hey! Color on a bird. You said brown. Survey said. You did well. Hey! Look in the cafe. Let's go.
Thank you.
Please remind everyone the answer the old reader gave us in 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name a state with the all-round worst weather.
New York.
The age when you felt grown up.
16.
A comic book character.
Superman.
Something you put on a hamburger.
Ketchup.
Try again.
Lettuce.
A color on a bird.
Orange.
Okay. State with all-around worst weather. Alaska was number one. You said New York. Survey said... The age when you felt grown up. You said 16. It was number one. Survey. Comic book character. You said Superman. It was number one. Survey said... Put on a hamburger. Ketchup was the number one answer. You said lettuce. If it's worth 20 points, you get another 5,000. Survey said... Color on a bird. You said orange. Red was number one. Orange, you need 17. Survey said... Also, puce wasn't there either, was it? Oh, what? 183. $5 every point. Total lob. 9-15. See you here on The Feud. Bye-bye.
Some departing contestants receive to perk up your plain meat meals. Reach for the spoon. Enjoy all six delicious varieties of Betty Crocker potatoes. Personal Touch, the beautiful woman's razor with a tortoiseshell look. Get smooth, show-off legs with Personal Touch, the cosmetic shaver. Pilot Pens, the razor point with the extra fine point and the fine liner that you can write through carbons. More than just something to write with. Town and Country Tableware by Washington Ford. Service for eight in mirror bright stainless steel with natural grained Fleetwood handles. Dishwasher safe from Washington Ford. This is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud. From Mark Goodson, Bill Todman Productions.